everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back. This is XCOM 2. We've got to destroy the alien relay for Operation Wolfmask, and we're taking out Andromeda, Loxley, Polo, L. Frank Skinner, and Wild. We've got a smoke grenade, flashbang, medkit, and a mimic beacon. So I think we've got our bases relatively covered. Andromeda, so going back a ways, I made a comment saying, if he screws up, we're going to cut his hair, or if he misses a shot, we're going to cut his hair, and I haven't done that, and I feel like because I didn't do it right away, I can't really punish him now.
Is being used by Advent to transmit critical data back to their network. The loss of that data will stop their latest project in its tracks, so we're moving in to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. We're expecting a strong contingent of security forces. Neutralize them and secure the site. Destroy that relay at all costs.
And so what I'm going to do is give him this one mission. And if it goes well for him, keeps the lovely locks. If it goes bad for him, powder bald. If you don't know what powder bald is, you got to watch the movie Powder. It's old. That bald.
Menace 1-5. The communications relay is up ahead. Oh. Move in and destroy the target.
Der Trupp ist verborgen.
Got a little glimpse there of some action. Okay, so we need to destroy the relay. We have a lot of windows, so presumably we could utilize our snipers with squad sight if we get close with any of our guys. L. Frank is our phantom, so if they get revealed, he could potentially still not have any issues, but I think we saw something there. I didn't quite catch what it was, but let's go and investigate nonetheless.
Get it covered. Looks like hostile over here.
Oh, geez. Okay. Yeah, we definitely saw something. So what is this? We got a shield bearer, a muton, a turret, and a trooper. Oh, two turrets. Yeah, that's even better. That's what I wanted. All right. So, Loxley. I want you to be able to be safe.
Closing on target position now.
And same with Nora, even more so just because you're a little bit more sensitive than the others.
Heading there now.
Health-wise. And then we could kind of move in here. I don't know how I feel about engaging with two friggin' turrets here, but what we might be able to do is if we could take out this group, we might be able to just plug away at the turrets with our Phantom up here and having the snipers take them down from range. So that's possible. Cannibal. Well, let's actually get you right in here.
Erledigt.
Affirmative. I caught my eyes on.
And there's going different directions, or they're okay. No, they're going to the same place. And actually, they're pretty. Oh, I think he's close to that car. If we could blow the car, this might actually be worth jumping on from here. I would definitely want full cover wherever possible. And that's one of the problems that I'm seeing here. I could pull Andromeda over to this side. Cannibal does have, he does have a point of armor. But, like, do I really want to sit in half cover against all of that? No. No, I do not.
Ich rück aus.
So, I gotta figure out where we can put Andromeda that we'd be able to see some of this stuff. Maybe just on the other side of this tree?
On the move.
Overwatch.
All right. Downside is that we can't get the car explosion. Oh, we got a little bit more action out there than I anticipated. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna open up here. We're gonna long watch. Nora, I'd like you to long watch as well.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Skinner, not sure I want you overwatching because I'm not sure how they're gonna react, and we're pretty flankable if they happen to run down here. Infernal. Are they gonna run this far? I mean, it's possible. I'll keep you free for now. So, Polo, what do you say?
To start this off.
Counting on Loxley and Nora right now. Come on.
Sie haben uns entdeckt.
Come on. Look at that thing. That's the long war muton right there. Nice shot, Nora. Oh no, that was not Nora. Come on, Nora. Oh shit. She got intimidated. And I think that is gonna flank our guy. Oh, maybe not. Not quite. It's friggin' close, though. Okay. Andromeda. I can't quite get out of all of this. But I could grenade the two down there and kill them. And then we have this guy. Let's just take a look here, first of all, at this fine work of art. Look at that guy. How cool is that? That's really cool. Yeah, that looks awesome. Now I want to kill you. Oops. Alright, so a couple of other options. The nice thing is we've got this guy flanked here. And so what I'm thinking is we could bring in Andromeda to take the grenade shot down here, right? We can keep Elfrank concealed. Skinner could come around to this side of the tree and take flank shots on the shield bearer. Now the shield bearer, he could grenade us. That's the downside. If he throws a grenade here, do they have grenades? I think they have grenades. But if he grenades this, that would suck terribly. But I'm hoping that he gets intimidated because he's flanked and he runs away. That would be great. So let's bring Tom back.
Throwing grenade!
Take out those two. Goodbye. Oh, that's cool.
Targets eliminated.
And then we could bring Skinner around the corner and start giving this shield bearer the what for. Oh, are you friggin' kidding me? Okay, maybe he won't be so intimidated. The other option is we take this shot. Break concealment. That's gonna really hurt us in the long run, so let's just overwatch here. Oh, nice. Okay. I mean, nice. It's not great. Stay hidden. Oh, shit, Skinner. Keep your head down. That's advice for everybody, by the way. And an Overwatch. That's freaking dirty if I ever saw it. Okay, Nora, you have a decent chance of hitting this guy, actually. I don't want to use more grenades. Like, at all. The other thing we could do is we could remove that Overwatch relatively easily. But then what do I do with that, even? It's not like I'm bringing in Cannibal to sit right in front of this turret. Okay, let's see if Nora can get this. 50-50. It would be a great start, that's all I'm saying. Shit, Nora. Okay.
Shot wide.
Okay, well, first things first, we're gonna heal.
Give him a heal!
Then, I think I'm gonna focus on just separating a bit. I could suppress that turret if I wanted to. It's not maybe a terrible option. At least that lets us put Andromeda to use. I could pull him back to this side.
Tired of waiting around.
Then we could try to suppress the shield bearer. It's a decent option as well. Let's see if Dog can hit him. It's 50%. There we go. He actually took a decent chunk of damage, too. I mean, maybe this is the time to kill him and just break the concealment. Come on. There we go.
Target safe.
So that's gonna turn off these extra shields for these guys, but they still have a shitload of armor. We can shred a bit of it. Nice. And then Loxley's gonna deal some damage. Probably can't quite kill it. Oh, maybe. We hit for 8. Let's go, Lox. Oh, close. Very close. Yeah, I don't think so. Now watch the suppress turret just wreck us. Nope. Spraying.
Advent reinforcements inbound.
Oh, are you freaking kidding me? Oh, this is really shit. This is really not good. Okay. We might have to... Okay, Nora's like our worst shot right now. Like, she doesn't have the accuracy. She doesn't have the scopes. Let's see if she can take this one out. There, nice shot.
No longer a threat.
And then I'm hoping that Skinner, 5-7, don't really trust that. I mean, actually, our best chance of killing this thing is with Elfrank. I said our best chance, not a guarantee, as is obviously demonstrated. Okay, these turrets are setting us back like fucking big time here.
Weapons
and
burning ammo fast.
Now we have a group dropping in, ready to try and
here
kill
I
us.
Come.
So there's also that to deal with. We've got two guys that we can overwatch. Loxley's overwatched as well. Or will be.
Moving to overwatch.
But even still, now I'm struggling with how we're gonna get in close to see that relay. Oh, and it's a mech. Like, this couldn't be worse. And a shield bearer. Could not be worse. We need all these overwatches to hit here. Every single one. Yeah, that's a good start. That's a great start. Loxley doesn't miss, so... theory, yes.
Happy now?
I am, thank you.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out, ASAP.
Like, I don't know. I don't know if we can actually get to the relay, that's the thing. How am I even gonna get... how am I gonna make it there?
Hey,
let's
now.
Start moving L-Frank. We'll okay, bring these guys close, I guess. Hey, let's see what the potential is from this tower. Watch, it's like... get an extra 10 turns to destroy the relay. That would be nice. Okay, soldier gains complete immunity from the next two attacks. Or everybody gets a defense and mobility boost. Damn it. Yeah, that's not good until we know more of what's going on. Nora, do you think you could kill this guy? That would just be swell. There we go. All of her shots are basically 50-50.
Kill confirmed.
Whether it's gonna happen or not. Hello.
Maybe a flesh wound?
And then let's get a reload in on Loxley.
I'm on it.
And we can come and flank this guy with two soldiers. These dodges, are you serious?
Just a little off. I'm all out.
I'm gonna bring Polo over here. Let's go, Polo. Oh, that sounds good. Is it good? Is he dead? I think he's dead. Yeah, he's dead. Good. Good, good, good.
Einer erledigt. Noch tausende.
Munition ist knapp.
I would give $1 million to be able to reconceal right now, though. But, like, it's not gonna happen. I have to move.
I'm on the move.
We might trigger some stuff, but I gotta go.
No,
like,
problem, boss.
I have no choice. Okay.
Hit it there now. Objective in range.
Okay, we can see the objective. Oh my god. What? That's insane. Holy shit, that's crazy. Two Vipers, Euton, mech, two Stun Lancers. Oh no, maybe not Stun Lancers. But still. Am I right? Or am I right? I do have an idea. I can't tell if I have vision of the of the objective, which sucks. And our snipers definitely don't see it. But if we lined up in like a... I wonder. We would need to be very sure of this, but... somewhere around here, maybe.
Moving out.
Let's see. Okay, actually, yes, that works out great. Nora has to reload, which means she will not be eligible to take it.
It's killing time.
Next turn, because we're not going to be close enough, but. If we stay on that same trajectory, maybe back here, but doubtful.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Oh, yes, she can see it. Okay. So now... now, the game plan is... flashbang literally everything? Is that possible? We're actually hitting everything besides the mech. And I think we're even hitting that Viper over there. We're hitting both Vipers. But then we are sitting here, half cover beside a car with an Advent mech that will most likely be launching grenades. So, the other option is what? What's the other option? I mean, we don't have any good cover anywhere.
Finally!
How close can I get Cannibal? It's too bad we can't use these mechs as cover, or these turrets.
Was ist da drüben?
So this is not a bad option. This hurts a lot of them and probably kills that Viper. Don't think it kills the mech unless the car really explodes, but I don't think that'll happen. The other option is to hit these two and that guy, but I think hitting this mech's not a bad start. Did the car kill the Viper? I think it did. No, it didn't. Wow, what? All right. Now, Tommy. Ugh. Oh, hello. Wow. Seriously, Tommy? I'm impressed. I feel like... oh, now it's gone. Why do we have that? Is it a weird bounce?
Frag out!
Is he actually doing that? Fuck, I'll take it. That's fucking awesome. For my purposes today, that's fantastic. Now, I feel a little bit more comfortable with what's happening here. Is this hitting the other Viper by the car? That should be.
You watching?
And who was- oh, and that was Tommy with the super launch. I don't know if that was a bug or what, but hey, in this scenario, I am not complaining one friggin' bit. We can aid protocol. I also think killing something would be beneficial. Um, Yeah. Let's aid protocol up front. No, let's move around this side. I wonder if there's like a weird... Because I think there was one point in the past too where it was like the launcher was like super far. And I wonder if there's a weird interaction with how it handles... Uh-oh. I wonder if there's a weird interaction with how it handles, like, cover being blown or something. Oh, God. Ooh, flashbang, save lives. That's all she wrote. We're not out of the woods yet. Not even frickin' close. Oh, shit! You'll be fine. Holy fuck. Wow. Holy shit, man. No, Andromeda, we need you! You cannot panic right now. Oh. Dude. Okay. I think Skinner might be able to save this disaster that's happening.
Transmission signal is fading. We've almost completed the transfer. This is your last chance to take out that relay.
Yep, working on it. Snipers, relay. Good shot, Nora. Relay down.
Menace 1-5, we confirm destruction of the relay. The alien transmission is down. Eliminate any remaining hostiles and move to evac.
Okay, so I can stabilize or revive. If I stabilize, I don't need to stabilize right now. Like, I can't revive them, so it's not really gonna... Well, actually... If I stabilize him, then I can revive him, no?
Let's see. Coming through.
Yeah, so now he's unconscious. And then we're gonna pick him up. Come on back, pal. Holy shit. Impressive.
Okay, bin unterwegs.
Think we can hit all three there, it looks like.
Köpfe unter!
Oh my god. He is gonna be out though for a long time and probably even for the black site, which sucks. But I feel like I'm counting my chickens a little bit early here. Oh god. What do we want to deal with? Vipers or this guy? Probably Vipers. What I would give for running gun right now.
Understood.
Let's move in
out.
A bit. Come on, El Frank. Wow. Okay, we got two Vipers. If they latch onto somebody, that's best case scenario. What I don't want them to do is latch onto Polo. Been through enough. Are we just... Oh, wow, okay.
I'm hit! Advent forces on the ground!
Oh!
Are you kidding me?
How many are there? This is ridiculous! Oh my god. We gotta get that mimic beacon in. No! Oh, that is friggin' dirty. Okay. Yeah, I see how you want to play this. Now I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Let's rock!
Come on, Tommy! I mean, that's not really your fault, but still.
Maybe a flesh wound.
Let's free him up. Oh, these guys and their dodges, I swear to God. It is like that we're having the worst luck. Okay, I have a plan though. My plan.
Heading to that location.
Is to move up top.
What was that?
Let's see if we can't kill this guy outright. Oh my god. Wow. Wow, 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 wow.
I need ammo.
I kind of need to heal. I should heal both, honestly.
Go heal him.
And then the plan. This will remove the poison. The plan is to get this mimic beacon out. Let's actually get a quick reload in here. Come on. Dodge this one, you prick. Okay, yeah, that's good. It's not dodging. Okay. Nora has zero chance to hit anything because Squad Sight's crushing her ability to do so. But I do want to get her out here.
Confirmed.
And we're going to launch this mimic beacon. Come on, Nora. Save the day. Yeah, get in there. Wow. Mimic beacon. That's like just a taste of their own medicine, you know? There should be a research project where you upgrade your mimic beacon to actually include dodge. Oh, no way. He doesn't see the beacon. No!
Watch the sides!
Oh, that fucking sucks so badly. Oh, man. These guys are just eating shit today. I'm surprised you didn't dodge that. Put him down. There we go. Looks like it blew him into another dimension. Okay. Nora, come on. You got this. You got this. Yes.
Enemies down.
Now. We don't see him, which means he's gonna come at us. We should be able to overwatch.
I'll give it a shot.
I think we're gonna go for this hack because now, whatever, if he's increased, it's one guy. But we can also start to improve our hacking. Turns out, at every successful hack that you get, it increases your hacking score by 5, so it's pretty cool. I don't care about the will, I just kind of care about increasing our tech score. So it's 65 now, and I think if we do the hack, it goes up to 70. I don't think we'll see it right away, but... And actually, I don't even know if it shows anywhere, but what it where it shows is the next time we hack, you should be at 70. Can I just say that this mission is completely bullshit? Like, how many enemies are on this map right now? How are we alive? We're barely crawling out of here. We're gonna have some of our top guys out for a very important mission. At least that's how it looks right now.
Affirmative, covering now.
Repeater, scope. Our soldier's unconscious, but he's not dead. Oh, we got the execution!
Oh my god.
Status confirmed.
Oh man.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Wow, that was ridiculous. And I actually forgot that we even had the friggin' relay to deal with. And just all the shit that happened in that mission. Okay, so I just need to review like out loud to make sure that I'm not imagining things. So, first thing, scout right away, and there's two turrets, a muton, shield bearer, and a trooper, right? Those guys, okay, grenades, fine, they're down, cool. Then, there's like three turns, maybe four turns left, we need to get to the relay. We dash, we get to the relay, we sit beside the car, right? We get our snipers into position to take it out. We have to guess on the positioning. I'm trying to line it up with the mouse. It works out great. We see get both of them right onto where they need to be so that on the last turn, they can destroy the relay. But inside, we had, what? A muton, two vipers, two troopers, and a mech. And then we were able to grenade a bunch of them with Cannibal, and then somehow Tom comes up with this extra gumption, says, I'm gonna launch a grenade that's gonna go, like, way further than it should, and I don't care, I'm just the commander, I'm gonna let him do that, if he figures out the way, go for it. And then, and then we kill the mech, because that was our biggest problem, we flashbang the entire group there, and then, okay, right, so then we find another, was it two groups in the back, somehow? No, there was like the... Oh, I can't remember the rest. Was it one group in the back? I don't know. But the Viper pulls us in eventually and reveals another group, which is a Stun Lancer and another Viper. So we go up top, try to get the aim advantage to go down and just kill the Viper outright. And what I should have done is went for the Stun Lancer, but I didn't. And I should have. But then we threw the Mimic Beacon. I'm thinking, okay, they're all going to shoot the Mimic Beacon. Turns out that the Stun Lancer can't see the Mimic Beacon, so he runs up, and he almost kills our friggin' Elf Rank Ranger, and he knocks him unconscious, which is not that great. But he's alive, so, I mean... At the end of the day... it worked out fine. Andromeda's keeping his hair. That's really the important thing here, is he doesn't have to cut those locks. But shit, man, that's a serious blow because we're getting close to the Black Site mission, and if we don't have these two dudes, not sure how I feel about that. Especially Cannibal with his extra grenades. He looks fine. Look at him. Cannibal looks great. I think he's gonna be fine. He's not even gonna be wounded. Shake it off. It was, oh yeah, and he was bleeding out. I forgot to mention that. I'm reciting everything that you just saw, but, you know, still, I'm processing. He's walking fine. No, they're not walking that fine. And Skinner, too. Shit. Oh, this is bad. Advanced repeater and a core. Great. Fine. Shield bearer autopsy.
Commander.
Man, that sucks. Oh! Oh, that's not cool at all. So, that means we need to get creative. I mean, we've got other people. So, Loxley's coming for sure. We'd bring Andromeda, Dumitrescu. We'd probably bring Luch, because he's got the rapid fire, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, so that could be very helpful. We're not gonna have any medkits. I may bring one just to like, just in case something really weird happens. We've got Aeneas. We've got Nora, but I think in this case we'd probably bring... Probably bring Zepernick, a squatty. Oh god, this is like not ideal at all. And we're probably gonna have to abuse Phantom, but this is assuming, of course, that we end up even getting there because we still have 9 days. So there's some intel. Okay, we've got 9 days. We're gonna finish up this scan here, I believe.
Avenger plotting new course.
No need to panic, I think. Okay.
Setting course for Mexico.
Let's take a look at what's going on. If this was a Grenadier, I would buy it instantly. Unfortunately, Mr. Kowalski, I don't really need you. Born in Aberdeen, Scotland, ex-military, member of Blackwatch Royal Regiment of Scotland, dismissed for being mentally unstable, but by his fellow soldiers described as best man we've ever served with, explosives expert. Explosives expert turned sharpshooter. Prior to invasion, HGV truck driver, and working with resistance ever since. And then Donatello, the Ninja Turtle, as an engineer if we wanted him. Do we have time? I think I have time to go to the black market. Because we get 6 days, 23 hours, 59 minutes, you know, so we still have time to scan. Barry Calhoun is here. That's interesting. Like that. Like that. Advanced perception might not be a terrible buy, actually. It's not superior. It's 50 intel. But it could be a decent pickup. I'm gonna buy it.
Setting
now let's go make contact.
Eastern US precinct.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Okay, so Advent mech breakdown
Advent
complete. Gremlin Mark II and blue screen.
Helping to keep the peace. As far as I can tell, they're fully automated and armed to the teeth.
So Gremlin Mark II is nice. Gives us a little hacking stat boost. It does some other things as well, but get into that later. Blue screen protocol is nice because we can build EMP grenades and blue screen rounds that bypasses the... does it bypass the armor? No. Blue screen... is good, yeah, okay. Blue screen's good against the, robotic enemies because it does bypass the armor, I'm pretty sure. It bypasses the armor of robotic enemies, and it decreases their tech score, so it makes hacking them a bit easier. Viper autopsy is now instant. That's, we might as well
grab it. Although I would expect to be growing more accustomed to seeing the clear intermingling of both human and alien genetic material, I must admit, this reptilian creature with such distinctive human features is surprisingly unsettling. Invasion-era reports include references to a species with some reptilian qualities, but nothing is readily apparent.
Look at that tongue hanging out. I love it.
I find it
so cool,
to say the least, that the subject so often referred to in the past as the Thin Man has now been revealed to actually be a genetic derivative of this wholly reptilian creature.
I like this. He says, of the many alien species our troops encounter in the field, I find the prospect of encountering an intelligent snake standing over 2 meters tall to be among the most disturbing. And this gives us battlefield medicine, which improves our medkits in the Proving Ground. Yeah, isolate if using our medkits. All right. Next thing we want to do, I think we'll probably do the shield bearer. Yeah, let's do
physically,
shield bearer.
The Advent shield bearers are quite similar to the bulk of Advent's forces, in that they are the product of careful genetic engineering that generally mirrors the human form. Most of their unique qualities come from a difference in equipment and armor. Components I'm sure Shen would have an interest in examining.
Okay.
I have to admit, there is something exciting about working under the more intense conditions found on the Avenger. Every decision, every development is of the utmost importance. There's no room for mistakes here.
I do want to actually read about Polo here. Some people have been saying that he has a really interesting bio. Let's see. Cannibal or rap cannibal, as he is known by most, left a not-so-successful career as a German rapper to fight the alien oppressors. Shit. All right. I guess, man. Good for you. It's cool. We got to make sure that we look at our... we have two advanced repeaters that we can use, and we also have the advanced perception. So plus 10, 8 aim. I thought it was plus 10, but it's plus 8. All right. Man, those guys being out, that really sucks. Like a lot.
Commander, we've got local resistance forces waiting to make contact, but we'll have to make the first move.
I hear ya. Come on. Come on. There we go. So with like a day to spare, we are getting out to the black site.
New objective added.
Okay.
Commander, we've established contact with the local resistance, and we can move on the Advent black site on your order. We should make sure our troops are fully equipped and ready for a tough mission. I'm guessing security will be tight at the facility.
We're making progress, Commander.
It's gonna
I've updated
be
our
tougher.
Objectives based on the latest findings.
Regional contacts located.
By the fact that some of our strongest guys are out. So proving ground projects are cheaper now. That's pretty helpful. I'm tempted. Let's see here. Got 281 supplies.
What can I do for you, Commander?
What else do we need? Don't have enough for a mimic beacon. Could do the mag pistol. Still waiting on the skull jack. Do we need the mag pistol though? I mean, we don't need it. It's not bad. Not gonna have the predator armor for the black site, which sucks. This is like not ideal. Really not. Wouldn't be bad to get the arc blade, but we're low on alloys there too. I'm gonna grab the mag pistol, I guess, because it gives us a little bit more flexibility with Loxley at least.
As far as I can tell, Advent's technology, along with most of what we've seen going on in the city centers, is based on variations, and in some cases, improvements of the existing alien tech used during the invasion. Luckily, the more common this stuff becomes, the easier it'll be for us to find components that can work in conjunction with the Avengers' hybrid systems.
Oh, look at Loxley spending a little time with Elfrank there. Got a few people in the med bay, but she's spending time with him, huh? Meanwhile, Andromeda pumped, doing sit-ups, because you need abs out here.
Get in.
Now, I think...
Avenger plotting new course.
I'm going to get like a day of scanning in here.
I've made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander. These shield bearers are not all that dissimilar from their various Advent peers. Their armor is perhaps the most distinctive feature differentiating them.
So, this is good. proving ground, experimental armor. Pretty soon, like, we're gonna get all these fruits of our labors here are gonna, like, things are gonna start to pay off. The proving ground is gonna start to pump out some ammo and grenades and armor and pretty much a bunch of other cool stuff. We could start to build predator armor soon. Like, there's a lot of things that could help us. Now, a facility lead is helpful because this is a guaranteed facility that we can attack at any time to kind of relieve some of the avatar progress. So I don't know that we need to do that right now. Maybe what we do is we start the data cache decryption.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
And then we could... There's our power coil shielded area open up now. So we should build power there and just get it done. Especially while we have the money.
Power relay construction initiated.
Put Sniper Wolf in there to speed that up. There we go. Oh, no good. We do have somebody in the advanced. I was like, oh, Jesus. And then, let's go ahead. And we can increase the project
our
speed.
Equipment is ready to begin assembly, Commander. Just give the word
actually,
and we'll build the Skull Jack.
We don't need the Skull Jack right away. We'll most likely get a few days of scanning afterwards. So let's put Amir here. Try and knock this down a bit. And then, yeah, we're gonna set up for the black site here.
Setting course for Eastern United States.
With 9 hours to spare. Wow. Let's autofill and see who we get. So it's not a bad grab here. Let's make utility items available. So Dumitrasu's coming, Andromeda is coming. Old Timer's coming, Pi's coming, Loxy's coming. I don't know about Wild as much as I would love to have her. I don't think two snipers make sense here. I do think another Ranger could be quite helpful. Just for crits. So let's bring you out. Thomas Zepernick. Let's go, let's find a unique color for you. Let's go like this dark yellowish. Young survivor, the one last local militia to openly resist the advent, Nicholas lasted for years. Oh yeah, right, we read about him previously. Let's do that. That looks cool. Okay, we could give you the weapon upgrade to get the advanced repeater. But I want to double check which repeater we have on Old Timer here. Oh, we don't have any. Let's throw this on him. There we go. So on rapid fire, that's every, because we're going to use this pretty much all the time. We'll make sure that he is well equipped for that. So we're going to get 10% on each of those shots. Plus, if we wanted to, we could even give him the advanced aim, which will knock him over 80. That's a pretty plausible thing to do, actually. She's got superior. And, I mean, we're going to be shooting with her every chance we get as well. So I'm going to give her an advanced repeater. Actually, we really shouldn't. I should hold off and wait for an expanded magazine because of Killzone that's coming very soon. We could give the repeater to you. Mr. Zepernick. The Let's do that. And then, you know what? I think it does make sense to give Luch here the advanced perception. With rapid fire, I mean, that's going to offset half the penalty, right? From 15 to 7 only. So that's pretty good, I'd say. But, yeah. We have the Haywire Protocol on him, so an increased hacking could be good. And I wonder if I could squeeze...
Hello, Commander.
I wonder if I could squeeze in this gremlin. Oh, wait, what did we get the... Oh, that's right! We got the alloys from clearing out the space. Oh, that could work out great, because, yeah, that could work out great. I think this is better than taking the arc blade, because if we run into robotic enemies, we have a much better chance of hacking them. The arc blade is good, don't get me wrong, but I just feel like we're going to rely on the shotguns for damage a lot more. So I'm going to go ahead and build the gremlin. And that's actually frickin' fantastic. That's really fantastic. Okay, so now we gotta load out our items here. Sorry, Nora. I know you want to be in there, but it's just not the right time. Oh, so... Grenades. Smoke. Do I need... I shouldn't say, do I need the smoke, because I never know. We might need it, we might not. Who knows? I'm going to take the med kit with Luch. Even though we can't really take the most advantage of it. Flashbangs. On you. And... Zeppernik. Mimic Beacon, I think. I wonder if we need to take smoke, or if it would be better to take a flashbang. I'm gonna say, in this case, we're gonna take a flashbang. I don't know. I'm gonna take a break, and I'll decide. But, for now, we're going out with this squad. Zeppernik, Aeneas, Loxley, Andromeda, Luch, Dumitrescu. With the Mimic Beacon, two flashbangs, four grenades, and a first aid kit. I may even want to take more grenades. I'm not sure. We'll see. Thank you guys so much. We'll see you guys next time. Wish me luck. I'm certainly going to need it. And best of luck to us on Operation Warhawk. See you guys. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.